Natural. It's too late. We're already streaming. That outburst, the whole world saw it.
It's gonna go viral.
How do you think I feel? I gotta be the DM, make goofy voices and act silly, and you know I hate doing that. So
you love to. No, are you the narrator?
That's correct.
Yay!
So Dungeons and Dragons is kind of like a video game before video games were invented.
Okay.
So.
Why are there so many people?
One person takes on the job of being the game engine, basically.
So that's you.
Yeah. And then everyone else has made a character that they are playing in the game. Now, because you have a human brain instead of a pre-programmed video game, in theory, the human brain can react better and give you more options and more things. So, in D&D, if you decide you want to do something, you could do it. So if I go into an inn in Skyrim, I might be able to sit in one of the chairs. And I sit in the chair. And then I take an apple out of my backpack, I eat the apple. That's cool. In Dungeons & Dragons, you could go into the inn and start eating the chair. You could jump on the table and moon everybody in the tavern and play a song on your butt cheeks. Like, you can do anything you want, but the characters in the game that are not players, the NPCs, the non-player characters, they're going to react to what you guys do, and the world is going to, the world's going to react to your actions.
Uh-oh.
All right. So, you guys should place yourselves in the tavern. And before we get started, you will need to have a reason why the four of you are all hanging out, enjoying brunch together on this fine Saturday. In the world of Dungeons and Dragons. That's actually the name of the world.
How is Dungeons and Dragons. A fine day when the world is always being attacked?
It's perspective. Like, they get used to it. So if a dragon doesn't attack, but
it's
maybe some zombies did, that's a good day.
And it's a good day because we're heroes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And not just random villagers running around getting murdered.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, normally
guess
it's pretty
what?
Bad to be a villager.
Yeah.
Last time, I befriended a goblin dog, even though my spell failed because...
Oh, see, that's that hiss I was talking about.
I'm a very nice
hear it?
Person.
Yeah.
I have on a heel. So I wouldn't chop somebody's head off because I'm ideal.
I don't know if it's from this or what.
I don't think it's from the microphone. Thanks.
It might just be the fan.
Maybe.
Alright. We should be good. It's obviously not enough people here. So these two characters, possibly from a different game, are in here talking to each other at the tables.
Alright, so.
Wait, they came through a portal from another dimension.
And then
a few years ago.
Vash the Stampede will be the barkeeper, innkeeper. He retired.
Yeah.
He had a hard life. It was a pretty hard
one. Yeah, typically he's a bouncer, but it's nice to finally own his own place.
Yeah.
He made it up. He worked. He worked through the hard.
All right, so you guys will be at this table here in the back.
Boom. Sorry. I'm
or if you're feeling particularly fancy, you could have one of those three private booths.
No, we can't afford that.
Sorry, I'm late. I ran into a group of zombies on the way here.
Wait, what? You ran into a group of zombies?
Yeah, it's the best day ever, right?
I'm really hoping one might be able
to. And then I tripped in a hole and fell into a hole full of maggots.
Alright, if you require a reason to all be together, it could be that you have all had your own independent adventures. So many, in fact, that you have reached the ripe age of level 2. You decided that the solo life was no good, and if you really wanted to advance your adventurer career, you needed to team up. So, having placed a Craigslist ad, you guys have all met up at this local tavern, the Mermaid's Mustache, and you guys are deciding how to go about business.
That's hilarious.
What will be the order of the day? How you'll divvy up loot? Whether or not NPCs should be hired to die for? I mean, to carry your torch, that sort of thing.
Maybe.
Yes.
Or we could have still done all that. But like we could have all come to this tavern, thinking that we wanted to stop doing adventure solo, and we all just bumped into each other.
Okay, yeah, the medieval version of Craigslist.
Like
ye old Craigslist.
Just old pegboard.
Yeah, a little pegboard. Each of you had placed your business cards next to each other's.
And mine was sad. I was lonely, and I really needed some friends. So I was just like, "Hey, anybody want to hang out?"
And we were like, "No."
To establish a little bit more about your characters, we're gonna go around the circle, and you're gonna tell me what was your business card like that you posted on the adventure board. So what was yours like?
I go last.
Okay, Steven, what was your business card like?
Mine was pretty sad and lonely. He was looking for a friend. He doesn't have much going on.
Oh, okay.
But he really wants to get some funds together because he wants gold teeth.
Oh, okay. Gold teeth. Nice.
He does.
Nice.
He does.
Mine was like bright and colorful, and it was like, I do bar mitzvahs.
Oh, bar mitzvahs. All right. Very nice. Of one of the oldest face in the world of Dungeons and Dragons.
Mine is me in a big circle of people holding hands.
Oh, okay. All right.
Because I'm ideal and bond.
Fair enough.
That's my background.
Answer that. Mine looks like.
What?
It had a willow tree on a tropical island, and it had a neon sunset with dark blue water.
Wow.
Nice.
It was really weird.
All right.
Had to pay extra Kinko's for that one.
Yeah.
That was a lot to print.
You guys managed to decipher each other's business cards. Looking around the room, you find each other, and you sit down to a delicious breakfast of elf toast. Which is like French toast, but more thematic to Dungeons & Dragons.
On my business card, I didn't know anybody on there.
They're making him pay?
Boy, we hope so.
On my business card, I didn't know anybody. I just said, come hold hands with me and take a picture.
All right.
I think I just...
It's very awkward. Within seconds of sitting down at the table, a tiny hand is holding yours. you look over and see a halfling ninja.
Oh.
I'm very tiny.
How tall is your halfling?
This thing shows up everywhere.
I have no idea.
The tallest halfling on record was 3 feet tall.
Yeah, it was like 3 feet.
I don't know how to tell. Can I help you?
Use your imagination. How tall are you? 2 feet, 2.5 feet.
How tall am I?
1.5 feet tall. Wow. Sort of a dwarf halfling.
Yeah.
All right.
How tall, right?
So let's go around the circle one more time. Give a quick introduction of your character, including how you are eating your elf toast.
Wait, my name is Monk, and then Key.
Oh. Monk is your title, Key is your name.
Yes.
An unfortunate combination. All right, we're going to start with Steven again. Introduce your character, their name, a description of them, and how they are eating their elf toast breakfast.
Okay, so it doesn't have... Okay. This is...
Do you want to help? Do you want to help Dungeon Master, buddy?
It's his helper.
Draco Silverwing is his name.
Draco Silverwing.
He's eating his elf toast with a side of squirrel.
What do you mean?
Ew, don't judge him. He knows how to live his life. He eats protein. He's not going to get weak on just elf toast. But he's having a good time. He eats with his hands. He doesn't believe in silverware. It's a waste of time.
Okay. Waste of money.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
That's the thing you're paying.
But he does.
For the meal.
But he's not very good at stealing, but he likes to do it. So every once in a while, he takes some silverware and shoves it into his pocket.
All right. Vash, the former Stampede, always the smart businessman, has actually just put out wooden silverware that he has painted poorly with gold craft paint. But you're level 2, you don't have a phrase.
It's shiny, I don't know this.
It worked.
It's shiny, that's all that matters.
All right, what is Wesley playing today?
Well, I am Empyrean Bartholomew the First.
Wow.
Yeah, I had to steal that.
Okay.
But, being a half elf, I like to think of myself as kind of high class.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So I'm eating with the wooden silverware.
Okay.
Very, very casually, very nicely. I think I'm better than the people.
Oh, okay.
Especially the Dragonborn.
that elf blood kind of shining through there.
Shining through. Pretty
okay.
hard.
All right.
Pretty hard.
Elves better than dragons. That's laughable.
All right, Alex, who are you playing today?
I'm playing as Key.
Key? Okay.
And I pick up the toast. I fall on the floor because it's about as big as me. And I'm laying under toast, screaming, "Help! I'm being squished by this toast!"
All right. The world's tiniest halfling monkey is being killed by her toast. It's gonna be a tough adventure. All right. What about you, Ivy? What do you got?
First, I take the toast off of the monkey.
Okay.
And then I lay it on the floor next to her.
Okay.
And then, I am a gnome druid, and I'm a forest gnome.
Okay.
Druid, actually. And I'm eating my toast.
Mm-hmm.
Well, actually, I grabbed my straw and started poking the toast, like, what is this?
Alright. You're poking your toast with a straw. Alright. What is your character's name?
My character's name is Lotus.
Lotus. Alright.
And she loves everything about nature.
Fair enough. In the
spirit
of Dungeons and Dragons, we're going to assume that everything that's done from this point on is done in character. So keep that in mind. What?
After she takes up the toast, I'm jumping on it like, "Die, toast, die!"
All right. You defeat the toast, gaining 3 experience points. All right. So, no sooner have you guys started to discuss forming your own adventuring party when adventure finds you. Da, da, da,
da, da. I could barely, like, the...
Is there a wild sheep going to run into the cavern?
Well, you're making a lot of assumptions there based on the title of this adventure, but you are correct. A sheep kicks open the front of the mermaid's mustache, bleeding plaintively, and obviously in a bad way. It's missing a lot of its wool. It's very dirty and dingy. A little bit of blood stains on it. Alright, you're hiding under the table. Smart. Alright, it begins frantically baaing at the whole room. Now, forest elf. You can speak with animals. So you hear the sheep.
Elf.
Oh, sorry, forest gnome. You hear the sheep crying for help. In what sounds like kind of a older voice. Like, "Help! Help me! Please!"
I'm like under the table.
Get that monster away!
Everyone turns to look at the spectacle that's going on. Confused.
Guys, we gotta help the sheep!
They see me standing.
Hearing you speak, the sheep turns to face you, and its eyes widen in joy. And you see its little weird square-shaped eyeballs just widen in joy. And it says, "You're a gnome! You can speak with the animals! Is that true?"
Yes, yes it is.
"Oh, thank goodness. It's been so long. I need help! I need help in a bad way!"
Yes, what do you need help with?
"They're coming to kill me!"
"Who are?"
The thugs hired by my apprentice. They'll be here any minute." Suddenly, you hear a loud boom of the door once again swinging open, and the shadow of a large, burly form is cast from the early morning sun, and it falls across the tavern. A huge, burly half-orc comes strutting into the inn.
Oh my gosh.
And behind him, you hear the yipping and snarling of wild animals.
I feel like we should run.
He is joined by a pack of wolves. This, of course, frightens and upsets some of the patrons, who begin to cry and run upstairs to
it
get away.
It almost scares me to death. Look at how tiny I am.
Oh no.
All right, full disclosure. These wolves are not actually on fire or made out of ghost energy. They're just the only wolves I have right now. All right.
Is this guy running too?
Who?
This guy.
Oh yeah, these two hold each other close.
No way.
Begin to weep openly, as paladins often do.
Yeah.
Especially alliance paladins. Let's get that
and
out.
And this person
tried to run away, but they walked into the wall.
All right. So what's happening here in Dungeons and Dragons is this role-playing encounter is attempting to become a combat encounter. So this guy looks very hostile. He's brandishing two huge machetes. And machetes. He's looking at some wool still clings to one of the machetes. He points one right at the sheep and it says, "All right, enough playing around. It's time to come home."
I'm gonna cast Charm Person on him.
Whoa, all right. You're casting Charm Person?
Yeah. So
go for it. So,
you tell him the charm, you must make a wisdom save.
All right, here comes that wisdom save.
That'd be 13.
13. He has no bonus to his wisdom.
That's
sad. Oh, 12. He is missed by one.
I hate it when the dice do that.
All right.
You don't want to do this.
Suddenly his eyes sort of glaze over a little bit. And little heart bubbles start to pop out.
Don't do it.
And he looks over at you, and he starts to hear the Dreamweaver music. He believes you can get him through the night.
Keep him warm.
All right.
You might have to take one for the team, guys.
Yeah, you are.
So he kind of just sways a little bit. The wolves restlessly yip and yap. And you hear them because you can understand animals. And they say, "Hey, what happened to the boss? Yeah, he's acting really weird. And there's like heart bubbles coming out of his head and stuff. If he doesn't snap out of it soon, we're going to have to do all the fighting ourselves.
I'm just staring at him.
Or wait for Big Boy to show up."
Oh, good.
I'm just staring at him. My bow and arrow's on the floor. I'm just like, "There's somebody bigger than the boss!"
I'm going to whisper to Steven and be like, "Hey, I want to hit him with something hard.
Do you mind if I sit here?" says the half-orc as he comes over to stand next to you. Go ahead and move the half-orc over next to...
I can't let anybody go.
He's just going to take a seat.
Oh, okay. What are we having for breakfast, buddy?
Too close! Too close! Wait, I whisper to Alex.
How do you whisper to me all the way across the room?
I know. A bigger person might be coming.
You know, I feel like we've been friends a long time, and that's why I feel comfortable telling you, we gotta take that sheep back to my boss. This is no good.
Why? Wait, what did the sheep do to you, sir?
No, it's not that hard.
Oh, he's actually a powerful elven wizard that my boss polymorphed into a sheep. And we've been keeping him prisoner this whole time.
Ask him who his boss is.
Who is your boss? Like, he seems like a good guy.
It's oh, Devin the Masterful.
How strong is your charm?
How strong is that polymorph? Oh, like a pretty strong one?
It's from a wicked, powerful artifact that there's no counter spell for.
Okay, alright.
Yeah. Mm-mm. Boss went a little crazy. He actually turned almost everybody into animals. All those wolves, they're just guards.
Oh, wait, what?
But the boss promised he'd turn them back if they did what he told them to. I got a feeling that's not gonna happen, though. You feel really weird telling you all this plot exposition. I just met you.
No, they don't. We're such good friends. You didn't really tell the wolves.
One by one, the wolves begin to let out howls. Howls of initiative rolling. You hear them say, "That's it. He's lost his mind. We're going for it."
Wait, I was just petting the wolves.
What?
And then they start howling.
Correct.
And fly me across the room.
All right.
And cartoon style.
Everyone takes one 20-sided die, and they add their initiative bonus. For most characters, that's going to be your dexterity bonus.
Yeah.
The whole game is pretty much just rolling dice and trying to get a high number.
And roleplay.
Is it still the same for me, Dex, or is it going to be?
Do you have anything that boosts it?
My dexterity is 17 plus 3.
It should just be a dexterity.
You don't have any, like...
My 16 plus 3. We're doing a dexterity check?
Basically, yep.
So I roll a d20?
D20, and then add your dexterity modifier.
Okay. 14!
14.
We've been added. 14, I think I got 6.
So do you get, like, extra damage if you attack the Warpoint's charm?
I got 6.
Or not paying attention.
You might have advantage.
Like, can you?
You definitely have advantage because you wouldn't see it coming, but it probably ends the spell.
This is an attack.
Yeah, it ends the spell and the creature knows he's going.
Oh, it lasts an hour?
Yeah, but it does last an hour. So, honestly, you could just be like, I could be like, "Hey, bro.
Yeah, we fight
help
for
us
you?
Fight these wolves."
I think I can do any half-on in the bonus.
Alright, the wolves are still unsure about what's going on, and also a little nervous about all these bystanders, but... they are ready to fight. And they're going to be going on a 6. What did you get for initiative?
14.
What about you, Alex?
6.
6.
Plus 3? Yeah.
Yeah.
What about you?
I'm 12.
12.
And I'm 10.
And
oh, 10. Cindy didn't want to pop this all off.
And just to verify names again.
Draco.
Draco.
And Bartholomew.
Bartholomew.
And the girl's laughing.
Try this guy.
I'm Key.
All right.
Key.
Key. And Lotus. Got it. All right. So, fortunately, there is a brave minstrel that is continuing to play this ambient tavern music while you fight. Because professionals always do their job, even when they don't feel like it. All right. So,
this must be
we're going to start with Lotus. What are you going to do, Lotus?
What?
It is obvious these wolves are ready to do battle. They want the sheep. If you're willing to let them take the sheep...
They also want me.
Nothing bad has to happen here.
They also want me.
We
do
have
they?
To save the sheep.
Okay, so what
are
you
gonna
do?
Me. They want to take me too.
Oh, okay, and you do it. Who's like falling from the sheep?
The wolves are like, I don't know who this girl is. I never met her. I don't know why.
What
she,
is he even talking about?
Yeah, I don't know why she was like, oh,
I
so bad.
I ask this every time. Can you move diagonally?
Yes, you can move diagonally unlimited in 5th edition Dungeons & Dragons. You can move and take an action and continue moving in Dungeons & Dragons.
The wolves are just like...
So keep that in mind. If you are next to a monster and you want to move, it would take all your movement for the turn and you could place yourself one space away, but that would be it. Basically, you have... disengaged. You can spend an action to disengage, and then you can move away from the monster without it attacking you. If you don't disengage from the monster first, it will attack you if you try to run away from it. Also, if you try to cast a spell against a monster that's right next to you, that could also cause problems. Alright? So, you have a cheat sheet here that you could probably share with everybody that explains some of the different combat actions. There you go.
The wolves are just all right. Staring at me like I don't care.
And
just
at any time during your turn, you can also freely talk to each other and to whatever bad guys and monsters happen to be there. So, what is the plan? Priority for the bad guys is to capture the sheep. You guys are completely irrelevant as far as they're concerned.
So is each of these five?
Yes, each square is a 5 foot. So if you have a speed of, say, 30, you can move 6 squares per turn.
Okay.
Hush. Hush a poo. Realistic wolf sound effects brought to you by Inky.
Very helpful. So, what's the 15-foot cone? Is it going to be one?
It'll be three spaces. One. Three spaces out, and then three spaces wide. So it'll be one, two, three. Like a T.
Yeah.
It'll hit like a T shape. So it would hit this space, these three spaces, and probably these two spaces.
Yo, yeah.
Now, in Dungeons & Dragons 5th edition, your goal in any situation is to have what's called advantage. So you have things working in your favor. If you have advantage, you get to roll two 20-sided dice, and you get to take the highest number from those two dice. So it exponentially increases your odds of success. If you are in a disadvantaged situation, then you roll two dice and you have to take the lowest result. Now, to keep math simple, you could have 20 positive things giving you advantage and one negative thing giving you disadvantage. They cancel each other out. So it's very important to minimize your disadvantage and maximize your advantage. And she's ran off.
That's it. All right. She feared the fight, so she fled.
Alex, your friend has abandoned us. So, Lotus had a lot of thinking to do about her turn, and she is taking care of that.
Down.
So, we're going to jump to Bartholomew.
All right. All right, let's think. So, turn. You're ready to really
are you teaching them how to play D&D, or do they already know?
Yeah.
No,
and then
since
work in. Yeah.
Send
them work. Alright, okay. So, yeah, I'm like, hey, bro.
Egg him go up all casual.
Like, really help us out. You're like, dealing with these wolves. Like,
yeah.
Yeah, you know, that'd be cool. I really like that. You know?
I'm hiding behind
him. Is it help?
You mean, what do you mean, help you out?
I can do anything, Ken. Stop him, turn, you know, tell him stop.
Just tell him to stop?
I mean, you can hurt him.
You want me to hurt him?
It depends.
Which one do you want me to do?
What would you rather
do? Hold on a second. He wipes some syrup away from your cheek.
Thank you.
Anything for you, buddy. Okay. You're my friend. I love you.
Tell him to walk up all casual like.
Yeah, well, like, yeah, yeah, start walking up there.
Alright, I'll walk up all casual like. Yeah, that sounds good.
Then try to kill the one in the middle.
Oh, okay. It goes against a lot of my, how I feel, my principles, but you know.
But it's for love.
A failed saving throw is a failed saving throw. Aww. The wolves
begin gather around
to yap and howl at his approach, thinking he's finally come to his senses.
You guys just and skip my turn.
Have him turn.
Yeah, we, him so we did, but you can go in a second.
Yeah, yeah. Maybe you should get behind him, boy.
You don't want to overcomplicate this. You don't want to overcomplicate.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. You're good. Will you guys
attack? Dad, I have a movement of 5. I can move 1 space per turn.
You can move 1 space per turn.
Man, we gotta really hold the deck. Right.
Well, hold on. Hold on.
A really weird deck.
I can walk through monsters.
I have to look up my notes on this real quick.
I can walk through monsters.
The wild sheep chase notes. There we go.
I can walk through monsters.
Ah, okay. You can walk through monsters?
Yeah.
Really?
I can move through the space of any creature that is of a size larger than me.
Which, when you're 1 foot, 1.5 feet tall, is everything.
I just run between their legs as fast as I can.
Alright, this half-orc, whose name is Guz, by the way, in case anybody was curious.
He's even asked.
He yelled that back to us.
Yeah. By the way, the name is Guz.
It's good to know. Thank you.
The wolves are unprepared for his arrival here, and so when he busts out his whirling blades attack, he has advantage on this bad boy. So he's gonna roll. He has a +5. Oh, wow. Apparently the effects of this charm spell are pretty bad, but he gets to take the 5 out of those 2 dice. So he has a 10 on his attack against these mighty wolves.
My armor class is 16.
Nice. Sadly, that is not enough to hit any of the wolves. But the wolves have been clued in that something ain't right with the boss. One of them begins to howl. We're gonna need the big boy! Which to you guys just sounds like howling.
Not to me.
Right. Are you gonna actively translate?
Yeah, tell us what they're
saying. Just gonna keep shouting out translations?
I actively translate.
Alright, alright.
That's what it sounds like to us.
I wanna yell to Gus, but that's a really nice dance move, man. You're doing really good.
I'm trying my best over here. The floor is slippery.
Are you wearing shoes? Because that might be a problem.
Good, that'll end my turn.
Alright, that brings us to back to Lotus. What is the plan, Lotus?
Do I attack the wolves or what?
I don't know, you tell me.
Yeah.
Okay.
You might want to wait for the big guy.
I can't move that far. Because, like, I move back in the room.
He's not realized that. Like, we're totally not.
Dad?
Well, that's what I was wondering. Is your charm affected by me?
Yeah, to me. Because, like...
Well, what's the question, sweetheart?
Because it's your charm. Not my charm.
It's my movement, actually, no. Wherever it is. What is my movement?
Your movement?
Oh, you were your
computer. It is 5.
Okay.
25, so you can move 5 squares.
Oh!
Okay.
Okay, thank you.
Yep.
Maybe we promise it that we're not friends or something. You can hit it.
I can't move through.
My friend Jake said someone cast magic missile.
You can't move through me.
At the darkness.
Can't you just kick me like a soccer ball?
You want to be kicked like a soccer ball? Is there any monk who doesn't want to be?
You get tossed. Exactly. Yeah.
Do you need some more time to plan? I know you were caught off guard by this attack.
No, I'm looking at my spell.
I know, but there's combat trying to happen here. No. Alright, so you're furiously going through your spell
book. Hear the notes.
Alright, now we go to Draco.
Draco.
I have a question. Can you see water here?
Yes, there's a fountain right there in the middle.
Yes.
Alright.
So, the cone for his breath weapon would hit 1, 3, 3, or?
Yeah, it would be, if you started it here, it would go 1, 2, 3, and then these faces. It would miss the sheep.
Oh, it's like a cross.
Well, it's like a T, so it would go, I don't want to touch your dice, there you go. It would hit like that, 1, 2, and like a T shape.
Okay.
Yeah.
And this guy's in the middle of four right now, so where is he actually?
Alright, so looking here.
How is that wolf walking?
He's standing right here. This guy's right here. He's in the fountain,
So you like move up.
There you go. You could just... So if you stood here, you could actually get the orc and three wolves.
Yeah, but then you
would break our friend.
Oh, the orc is your friend, yeah. So if you stood in the fountain, you could hit these two wolves.
Yeah, that's a...
The wolf's like stretching across the stones.
These miniatures are pretty aggressive in space. Alright, so you move up, and you unleash your breath weapon. What does it do? What do they have to do?
Breath weapon. 15 feet. Each creature in the area must make a DC constitution save. 8 plus my con modifier plus... proficient. Well, theirs.
Okay, so it's going to be 10 plus... What was the...
Con modifier. Your 2 con modifier. Plus proficiency. With
so they got to make a 12. Wow, that's a pretty high difficulty.
Yeah.
All right, wolves have a plus 1 to this. So here we go. Rolling for the two different wolves. Oh, neither made it. They've taken full damage from it.
2d6.
Okay, so you're going to roll 2 six-sided dice.
I don't think those people who have been shaken. Oh my god,
10 damage. What sort of damage does this deal?
Cold.
Alright. So, the fountain freezes over as the dragonborn sorcerer lets loose his icy breath weapon. The wolves are covered in a rime of ice, their fur frozen into spikes. The one wolf's foot stuck in the frozen water inside the fountain. They are still alive, but barely. You see, a lot of the fight has kind of gone out of them. All right, that brings us to back to Lotus. Are you ready now, Lotus? Or do you need more time?
Do you have other pencils? Marks and stuff.
I might be able to create a distraction for the wolves.
Here you go.
But they're frozen.
Thank you.
Are they frozen in place?
All right, what are you gonna do?
Can they still attack while they're frozen?
Yeah, yeah.
It's just flavor. I might be able to create a distraction for them.
Okay.
So that they don't focus on us.
All right, what are you going to do?
Minor illusion?
Minor illusion. All right, what are you going to make the minor illusion?
I think I'm going to make a sound.
Uh-huh. What's the sound going to be?
It's gonna be like footsteps.
Footsteps.
Ask what the boss looked like.
All right. Of what? Like footsteps of what?
Yeah, we
could.
I got
a giant footstep.
That's something very big.
Okay. Where's it gonna be coming from?
It's going to be coming from behind these guys.
Okay.
So that they turn around.
All right. They're gonna try to make a wisdom check. To make sure that they don't turn around. Well, let's see what's happening.
Hold on, wait.
What's up?
I'm not sure I can do that, though. I'm not in close enough range, so I'll have to move first.
It says here you get a range of 30 feet for it. Yeah, so you'd have to go all the way over there. Alright, you want to think about a different action then?
Yeah.
Alright, so back to the spell book.
Alright.
That brings us to...
Yeah, you could pick her up and throw her just like she wants.
That brings us to the sheep. The sheep is currently not engaged in combat, and while he is hiding under the stable, he feels that it might be even better to run his hiney all the way back here and hide in the very back of this booth.
He's munching on some hay.
He cries out, bleeding constantly. If I was in my true form, I would destroy this entire town and everyone in it! That's how mad I am right now!
His true form is just like a little old man with a How much
experience is that sheep worth?
In his current form, at least 5 experience.
Yeah, but if we damage the sheep, can we kick him out of Follymore?
Guys!
You can try anything you want. It's Dungeons & Dragons.
Do I know that?
Anybody want it?
snack? Like normally, like if you
anyone want a snack?
You can't agree. You're trying to figure out what to do in the game.
You can do like
Alright, you hear loud thudding footprints coming from outside. And you hear people out on the street screaming in terror. I've never seen anything so horrifying! Run for your lives!
Okay.
All right. That puts it at Alex, the monk key's turn. Yeah.
Okay.
Currently, your party's newest recruit and the Dragonborn are up there meleeing five intelligent wolves.
So did the sheep go...
NPCs are also have to go running away.
Or is this...
And these two are stealing everybody's food off their tables.
That's fun. Did the sheep have to go up the steps?
Oh, to get in there?
Or is it...
No, he went between some railing. He, like, did one of those little sheep hops. And he...
Whoop, like, standard between, sheep hop.
Yeah, standard sheep hop. The one used for counting them.
Yeah.
I think we should start moving upstairs to get an advantage when the big boss comes.
Yeah, we're good. I got an idea.
All right, monkey, you got a plan? You can move five spaces, or possibly more, because I think monks are pretty fast. Mm-hmm. What does it say for your speed?
Okay, 35 feet.
That so you can move seven spaces. All right, so where are you going to go with those seven spaces? You going to run up and start boxing some sheep?
Some wolves?
Some wolves? Oh,
are you going to punch the sheep?
Sorry, I'm so in the bad guy, but I can't.
You want to go beat the heavily injured sheep?
Adventure over.
Sorry, I have a hunting trap in my bag.
Okay.
I'm going to start hitting this
don't,
one.
Don't overthink it. I know you can what do you anything. It sometimes be overwhelming. Sometimes just chucking a spell might be the best thing. Or beating something up.
I could run up and beat it over the head with a club.
Okay.
Yeah,
alright. Alex controlling the monk key has moved up. Are you gonna attack? Alright, you gotta get next to your target. Stand right in front of the door.
Right in his butt.
Alright, attacking this wolf's butt. Alright. Luckily, fluffy tail, all up in the air. That bullseye, right there. What? All right, go for it.
He's building the scene for us. Yeah. He wants us to be
immersion,
there.
Ambiance.
You can smell.
Imagination.
Wait, what
are we?
I'm gonna use this.
All right. Which weapon are you using?
What are you using? Your short sword. All right, roll a d20 and add whatever number it tells you to add. What does it say?
It says weapon attack plus 5.
All right, so d20 plus 5. You're trying to get the number 13.
12 plus 5?
12 plus 5, yeah. Yep. All right, that hits. Now you roll a damage die. What does it say for damage?
Damage?
Yep.
1d6.
All right.
Plus 4.
So add roll a six-sided die and add 4 to it.
6, 6, 6, 6.
4 plus 4 equals 8.
Oh, it looks like one of our cameras died.
Eh.
Yeah, we're fine. We'll keep going. Oh, did you die, little camera?
He did tie himself up in it.
Oh, yeah. Inky unplugged the camera.
Inky's all got right. Warrants.
We'll fix it after this adventure's over. Let's keep going. Not this adventure, but this encounter.
Okay.
All right. So you hit him for how much damage total?
Eight
damage.
Eight.
All right.
Plus
you.
Four. Is that what
you
said?
Yeah. Four.
What martial art move do you use on this guy? Kick, punch, headbutt. You headbutt
suplex.
His butt. You headbutt his butt.
No.
Suplex. You pick the wolf up and you slam him. Yes.
A 1 foot. Yes. Fisherman suplex.
I go like this. Cartoon, I
think
1 foot, bam!
Oh wow, you pick the wolf up by the tail and you start slamming it back and forth. Alright. The wolf is in a bad way. He lets out cries of anguish as you do so, howling and yipping painfully, but he's still going.
Wait.
Thank goodness for those hit points.
This is my face.
Alright, is Lotus ready to take a turn? Has she decided what she's going to do?
Yes.
Alright. What is she gonna do?
He wants to walk over and hit fly over.
Alright.
If she can reach
So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Crowd in there. And you can hit the one that she was slamming back and forth.
Wait, I'm like slamming right him back and forth. I smile at you.
I'm gonna hit him over the head with my staff.
Alright.
Alice is looking right here.
I say hi, and I'm just like,
it's looking like a lot of fun to kill everything.
Like, I'm holding the wolf, I'm like, hi. I'm swinging him back and forth.
What does the staff do again?
The camera?
We'll fix it later.
We'll fix it.
Inky.
Curses.
The true villain.
What does the staff do?
What does your staff do? Over here. You don't actually have it written down. Okay.
Killed the camera.
Your staff's going to attack with a plus, +3 to hit, and it's going to do a d8 +1 damage.
Okay.
All right. So roll a 20-sided die. Add 3 to it. You're trying to get a 13.
Hmm? Should I roll again?
Sure.
Ooh.
No. That delirium. Yeah.
I'm doing these things.
All right. After much deciding, going through all of your stuff, checking every spell you had, constantly translating all 6 like entities in the room for everyone, you're finally like, forget it, I'm just gonna hit him. You run up, but it's just too much of a mosh pit right now, and you get pushed away by,
I know what happens. But the staff, like, brushed its one tail, and it started, and it giggled because it brushed its tail.
So you tickled him. Alright.
Tickle attack.
I tickled him.
That brings us to the wolves' turns. Alright.
Boo. So
the wolves are about to teach everybody just how deadly 5th edition Dungeons and Dragons
she ran
is.
Away. Because I was about to smash her with the wolf.
Alright, so one wolf is going to go after Draco. One wolf is going to go after Guz. This wolf is very scared of the monk, but it's fight or flight at this point, so he's going to go after the monk. These two are going to try to move around.
He's terrified. But it's tiny, 1 foot 6.
Attack
the dragonborn?
They're pretty bad.
That's cool. He's strong.
This one is sniffing out the sheep and trying to head over to the sheep. All right. So let's start establishing some attacks here.
Like...
Wolves have a special thing called pack tactics and keen hearing and smell. Okay. So the pack tactics mean it has advantage on attack rolls against a creature if at least one of its allies is within 5 feet of the creature and the ally isn't incapacitated. So this guy's ally was not in place yet when he was going to attack, so he will just attack you normally. Here we go. This is at +4 against your armor class, a 22.
Does he have to react against the other guy?
Nope. As long as you're in melee and you're performing melee, nobody gets those reaction attacks. Now, higher up in level, different characters and monsters will unlock reaction attacks that they can activate at certain times. Wow, people are donating some money. Alright, thanks people for donating money. Alright, so he hits you.
So what does shield do?
We're sacrificing our sleep time.
What does shield do, the spell? I think it protects you against, like, missile attacks. What does it say?
Well, it said an attack or a magic missile.
Okay, so you want to kick it in? Because you can use it as a reaction.
Yeah, it says hit by an attack, though. Is that just
gives
targeted?
You a +5 bonus to your armor. Would that put you above 22, though?
Who wants to see
some
AC? +5? No, you need 21.
Now, you can use this attack to activate it, and it will last through the rest of your round. So when the next one goes to attack you, it'll still be in
effect. But I can still reactivate it then.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. So this one is dealing damage to you. Oh, dang. That's a lot of damage. He just did 9 damage to you with one bite. And you must succeed on a strength saving throw, DC 11, or be knocked down as he pulls you off your feet.
So in that case, do I want to cast it before I get knocked? Like, what's knocked down?
Knocked down just means you're prone. You have to use, like, movement to stand up on your turn. And then people attacking, you're going to have advantage. But the next guy attacking would have had advantage anyways. Prone does actually make you harder to hit with ranged attacks, though. So sometimes dropping down when you're being shot at isn't a bad idea. All right. So that drops your HP significantly, but not enough to kill you yet. But we're getting there. All right, the next wolf goes, and he's going to attack you. He has advantage now. Ooh, no! Good thing he had advantage, because that would have been a terrible miss with a one. But this puts it up to 17. You're gonna, yeah. All right, you proc your shield spell, and a magical icy shield of magic appears and deflects the attack from the wolf. And it will stay in effect until the wolf's initiative comes up again. So you'll have that plus five armor until the wolf's next turn. This wolf is turning to attack its former boss because he doesn't respect his authority anymore. Oh! No! Critical hit! That, in 5th edition D&D, criticals are not the worst thing that could ever happen. Unless you're rocking like magic items and special abilities. So all it does is max damage on a crit. So he takes 10 damage, just like that.
I took 9 and that wasn't...
Right, and it wasn't a critical. So see, criticals are cool, but they're not like the old days where, I ripped his arm off. All right, so poor Guz. Guz just took 10 damage.
Is Guz dead?
Is Guz dead? Guz is totally fine. But Guz is going to get a new chance to break out of that charm spell from taking damage. Alright, here we go.
Fail!
I can do it.
What do you need? A 13?
13.
Oh, he's still there! He's still there!
Look at this.
That really hurt! Why are you attacking me? I thought we were all friends here!
It's okay, man. I believe in you.
If you believe in me, that's more than enough. I'll keep fighting. Alright, and the last one is attacking Little Monkey. What is your armor class, Monkey?
15, I think. Isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, 15.
Yep.
Woo!
Good lord.
Alright, he has hit you with a 23.
Oh,
these wolves is hungry for violence.
They really don't like
Oh, them. But you take 3 plus 3, 6 points of damage. Do you need a pencil to keep track of your hit points?
How many?
Ivy, can you go grab some pencils? Alright.
It says it up there under your. Yep. Like in the top.
Underneath the armor class, it'll say hit points.
Oh, that's 17.
So 17, and you just took 6.
11.
So you're down to 11. If you get to 0 HP or less, you fall to the ground, not dead, but dying. And then a convoluted series of things happens where hopefully you die, but you'll probably live, because 5th edition is a little generous in that way. At lower levels, it is easy to get overkilled, though. So if any attack deals enough damage to you in one hit to take you to negative your maximum hit point value...
I know what he did.
You're just dead outright.
He just went like this.
Which at low level can actually happen. Higher level, it's pretty extreme. You have to fall off a mountain.
You crush my huge bones.
Fall into lava. Yeah, you need some extreme stuff.
I'm laying on the ground.
I will avenge you!
You just had to flip me down.
And that brings us to the end of round one. We're going to go into round two. Lotus's initiative has shifted. Are you looking for pencils? Those are glow sticks. Those are not pencils.
They're not.
No.
Sorry.
All right.
They're pipe cleaners. They're pipe
cleaners. Ask your mom. Your mom knows where everything is. Yeah, I just put it out there for the whole internet. Yeah.
I have a dart that can reach 20 to 60 feet.
How many spaces is 60 feet?
Space is 5 feet.
Yeah, so 12.
Okay, and I may shoot.
Alright, so now we're into round two. Round two is starting with Bartholomew.
Alright, first thing I want to do is I want to cast Minor Illusion on the door and make it look like a wall.
Oh, okay.
So, like, hopefully the big guy is dumb. And he's like, oh, there was a door here.
Fair enough.
And then...
Amazing. Now that will take your concentration to keep it going.
Yeah.
Okay.
But I'm still able to move, right?
Yes.
Yeah. So am I able to use my full movement to jump up here and try to get in the
tunnel? Oh, okay. So you're going to go ahead and hop over the railing?
Yeah. So it's making like an athletic
check. It's pretty basic. You're just going to need like a DC 5.
All right. Well, 18.
All right, no problem. You vault with your elven reflexes over the railing. And the wolf snarls at you in anger that you are getting in between him and his quarry.
Alright, I'm going to turn to him and be like, hey, how exactly does this magic work? If, like, you hit 0 hit points, do you turn back? Is there no way to turn back?
From under the table, the sheep baa's at you. Unfortunately, the translator is deep in the midst of combat and cannot translate for you.
I'm just gonna go,
assuming that if you're talking to him, you must speak with animals. He is giving you the whole story. He won't stop. Yeah. He's explaining everything.
I'm like, okay.
Got it.
Oh, wow.
Understood.
Okay.
Here's an erasable green color pencil.
That works.
All right.
Mm-hmm. All right. So your turn is over then?
Yep.
You've cast a spell. You've jumped in the way of the monsters. That brings us to Draco at 10.
Draco bleeding himself. Okay, so
you're getting mauled pretty hard, so you might want to like.
And you're prone.
And you're prone.
Well, did I so have to roll to save the prone, or
no.
I just got knocked down?
You just knocked down.
All right.
Is standing up an action?
It's half your movement.
Yeah.
Do you get attacked for it, or?
No.
Where have you gone?
So I can stand up.
Just like I said, I would.
Oh. You still have half your movement, but if you move, you get attacked. They're gonna attack you.
Yes, a prone creature's only movement option is to crawl, unless it stands up and therefore ends the condition. You have disadvantage on your attack rolls, and attack rolls against you have advantage if they're within 5 feet of you. Otherwise, they have disadvantage.
The waitress has come.
And to crawl away, they attack.
Unless you use your action for the round to disengage. So you'd be using your action to disengage, then you could take your full movement, and nobody could get attacks on you. Might not be a bad idea to get out of there.
Yeah, you're
no maybe crawl under a nearby table or something. Pull some chairs in there, make a little fortress.
Yeah, yeah.
Go right. I have a movement of 30.
That you're gonna like.
Can we join
crawl.
You?
So you crawl away and hide under your table fortress.
I guess
All right.
Hey, can we join
the
you?
Wolves cry out, "Coward! Coward runs!" Which just sounds like barking. Or do you translate that? That's close enough for you to translate. Are you a little distracted right now?
A little distracted.
A little distracted.
But I give them hand gestures that they can't
universal
translate.
Universal language. Yes. Sign language. All right. Cool. So that brings us to the sheep. So the sheep continues to excitedly explain to you the entire story and everything that happened and all the different formulas he's thinking about and all that.
I'm just going to keep going. Uh-huh.
Meanwhile, outside, you hear a horrible scream. Sort of a... Let me see if I can find it for you.
I don't think we need to hear it.
This is pretty terrifying. No, that would be a dolphin. how long do I have to wait for the scream?
Oh my god!
You hear that? You hear that? Oh, it's horrifying.
It's like a screaming maggot.
And then you hear
that's what I imagine
someone outside scream, "He's gonna smash the wall!"
You might not want to be in that doorway when he smashes the wall.
You might want to move.
But you want to punch that wolf in the face first.
I was planning to crawl under all the wolves. I was planning to just go,
So a massive 7.5 foot tall rabbit smashes open the illusionary wall. In his mind, though, he feels like the Kool-Aid man. He just busted through an actual wall.
Yeah!
No, he didn't have to roll a check or anything. He just woof right there.
Oh!
Where does momentum go, though? Brother just threw through an illusion.
Oh, well, technically, we're going to give you a chance to not get hit by this guy.
She's a monk.
So you're a monk, so you get a chance to avoid this. So make a dexterity save. The difficulty is 10.
But that's if he found the doorway.
Plus 3.
What?
My dexterity is 17 plus 3.
Well, no. All
right.
So you roll, and then you.
You have a. I believe dexterity is a monk thing, so you actually have plus 5 to this.
Really?
Yeah. So go ahead and roll it.
I have 11 plus 5.
All right. You jump into this nearby space, but whoever was standing behind you might be about to get clocked in the face by a massive bunny.
Guys, no.
No! No!
I can hear the concern in your voice
yeah.
for your friend.
Is there collision? Guys that hit the other wolf.
And they just all die.
Yeah, everybody. Hey, the wolf has like one or two hit points left.
It's like Kingdom Death. They get moved back.
Next turn, I was planning to crawl under all
Where
these.
Where did all the grape jelly come from?
Me?
You can't play games without grape jelly.
I have to make The cocktail.
Oh my gosh! Another critical weenie. Against grudge.
Like, you know that meatball sauce? It's grape jelly and ketchup.
Guzz, really? Can I borrow that die, please?
Guzz. Oh my gosh! Guzz just took 20 points. No, not 20. I'm sorry. 16 points of damage from a critical hit from the rabid grizzly bunny.
I love Grizzly Bunny.
I need to check my notes, but I think that might be the end of him. Nope, he's still going.
Oh god.
Wait, he just whips around.
But he is going to have advantage after that hit for breaking free from your mind control, you vicious evil thing you. So here we go.
Punch me in back.
Alright, there he goes. That punch slash slap to the face finally. You see, like, just sort of a red-purple coloration start to spread all over his face, and he begins to look around the room for the half-elf who made him look like a fool. He remembers licking his thumb and wiping syrup off of your chin.
His face is, like, as red as a tomato.
Yes.
Steam's coming out.
Nose, ears. Oh, it's critical meltdown now. He says, it's not just about the sheep anymore. They all die. All of them.
The bunny's like,
Can I yell out like,
come on, man. More of them. Your friendship was a lie. I feel used.
You can't prove it.
All right. That brings us to.
He picks up his foot.
No.
Alex and Ivy. Who's going to go first? Go for it. What are you gonna do?
Crawl out of here. With my nimbleness.
Are you gonna fight the grizzly bunny, or are you gonna?
No.
Are you gonna disengage?
You can squash me like a cockroach.
So you're gonna disengage and leave?
Yeah.
All right. You have 7 movement. Where are you gonna go?
I'm gonna crawl through him.
Oh, that's right. Cause you can move through people, right?
Now I'm thinking I should have
just do.
Does a monk need to disengage if they can move through enemies?
I'm thinking you could still. They still could take a hit.
Oh, okay.
It just thought. Wait.
So you went 1, 2, 3, four, 5.
Mm-hmm. You're in range of my dart now, Wolf.
Oh.
It can reach up to like 12 feet.
All right, Ivy, your turn.
It can reach 12 spaces.
To kind of keep it, you know, get it organized here. This wolf right here and this wolf right here are in a bad way.
Isn't the wolf that I was beating
this
up?
Wolf right here is in a bad way.
Very bad.
This wolf is at max HP. This guy's in a bad way. And this guy's at max HP. You are currently next to 2 mid-boss level bad guys and a whole bunch of damage dudes. Your entire party has fled from the melee. You are the only one there.
Maybe I could attack.
What kind of magic? Do you have area effect magic?
Yeah, do you have any attack spells?
I'm sorry, that bunny just squashed me like I'm a
Do you have one that'll hit 3 people?
I think. No. I can do one thing.
I just came up with the perfect insult from the bunny to me.
I thought you
I
were
could
a bunny.
I
could
do one thing.
What
I
have
a sized
do?
Head. I feel like I should run away for something.
Okay, so why don't you spend this turn regrouping? So you're going to disengage, and you've got a speed of 5 squares, so where are you going to go?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
All right, roll an athletics check with a DC of 5 to jump that railing.
There's a railing?
Yep.
Athletics?
Huh. You did it. Yeah. All right, so you're up on the ledge, where another wolf is barreling down on you.
Leave me alone! All
right.
I can shoot him with my dart.
How's nimble work?
I don't even see it. But I know you get +10 to your movement, or you get 10 more feet.
Me like a pug, bunny.
I don't know what that is.
Alex, can you pass me your character sheet?
Yes.
Well, she said 35, so it might be added already.
Yeah, no, but yeah.
Halfling nimbleness.
Yeah, it probably is.
Armor defense, armor movement.
No, it's halfling. That's not
Like yeah, it just lets you move through the space, so you will not be able to attack this turn. You're just able to move around. All right. It's going to be rough. There's a lot of bad guys here.
I just wanted to get out of that bunny's space.
All right. This wolf, he's all mixed up. He's all angry. He's going to lash out at this nearby paladin.
Oh, no!
hugging the other paladin for help because alliance paladins can't do anything right. All right, he attacks.
Oh God!
Savaging that random NPC. 4-7 points of damage. At the sight of his own blood, this alliance allied paladin faints. Because that's how big of a weenie members of the alliance are. Alright.
For the horde.
Yes,
yo,
for the horde.
Jeremy!
For the
horde.
Yeah, the other paladin falls to his knees. No!
Jeremy!
Poor Jeremy.
Come back when I made you, Jeremy.
Whoa.
Come back!
Alright, that brings us to the other wolf's turn. This guy's going to nip out after the monk.
I'm glaring at the guy that's just like this.
No!
These are gonna go 1, 2, 3.
Oh, jeez, there's a
5. And he's gonna go after you, but you will have
table defense.
Table defense. Yeah. So he'll just make a regular attack against you.
I dropped a chip. Look! I dropped a chip. No, you're going the complete wrong direction. Look, I dropped a chip.
The boss did say everyone dies, so they will just start attacking everyone. He has advantage on this paladin.
Oh my god.
Woo! Crushing him. So as...
Barret's rolling to murder people.
As Jeremy's friend cries out in anguish, he is savaged by a wolf.
Oh,
taking a bunch of damage.
Well, guys,
all right.
That's a good one.
Attacking the dragon under the table.
He's getting bit by the wolf.
You still have your shield up?
Can I shield myself and the table?
I have an idea.
Make it a really nice shield.
I mean, you're a sorcerer, right? You can cast the same spells over and over again. Yeah. You may want to shield again, because I'm pretty sure I got you. All right. So, a little force field appears around your table fortress.
Wait.
And he is unable to get through.
The wolf that killed Jeremy.
Wait. What?
The guy.
He's trying to kill you.
He screamed Jeremy.
Oh, okay.
And then when he died, he screamed his own name.
Wow. All right. 17. Does that hit you, monk? Your armor class? Wow.
No, man.
Minimal damage. 5 more damage. So you're keeping track, right? You took 6 last time, you took 5 this time. Make sure you're keeping track of this.
I can heal her.
And that
is.
Yeah,
you can.
But after the battle.
And Guz. Guz wants to go, and he knows exactly who he's going for.
And his blood rage.
Don't be like that, baby.
Blood rage is a different game.
Yeah, come on, man.
Blood rage is a different game.
All right, he's going to try to hop the banister. He does. And he's going to attack you.
She screams.
Somebody
17.
That'll hit.
All right.
He just got to move right past me.
From under the table?
He's tripping.
I mean, you wanna lash out at him?
Yeah.
All right, go for it.
This is for play.
Go for it. Lash out at him.
I'm gonna bludgeon him.
I'm glaring at the wolf.
Bludgeon him. Kick a chair in his way.
Like trip him as he walks by.
So, cantrips. Just you can just cast them all day.
Yeah. They never run out.
Isn't that with attack of opportunity? You can only do melee attack.
Is that what it
correct.
Is?
Correct. Yeah.
Okay.
You,
so
you need special training to reaction with spells. Okay.
So yeah, I'll attack him with.
Your big
quarter staff. Yeah, well, quarter staff. I'm under a table, so.
Yeah, like
attacking with a quarter staff seems like.
You need to trip him.
Yeah,
just throw it out there.
Yeah.
But you gotta swing. Swing with a quarter staff under a table.
Try your best.
Yeah.
I also have daggers to just stab
him. Okay, stab him in the ankle.
I think.
Yeah.
Just cut his
ankle shank.
Does he have advantage or disadvantage on this?
Ooh. I think he's got a surprise balancing out his disadvantage. We'll make a regular attack roll here.
Okay.
Make sure you hit him, otherwise I'm gonna get really messed up.
Oh, I'll use the dagger since it's.
Oh, we stopped our music. We should probably. Vash the X Stampede throws some coins into the jukebox so it starts back up. There we go.
Okay.
I'm gonna stab him.
They were quiet for a minute because they were gonna be murdered, but everything looked like mellowed out.
Everything got real quiet while they were shouting Jeremy over and over again,
yeah.
And then. They started up again.
Plus 3 to attack.
All right, he's only got an armor class of 14.
Ooh, that did not hit him.
All right.
No,
so you
swing.
You're just gabbing.
All right, so with that out of the way, he hops over the banister.
What about the sheep's attack?
True.
The sheep's in melee.
He hasn't moved past him yet.
And hiding like crazy. All right, here we go.
I know the sheep can do. I can bite him on the face.
So did he hit you is the question.
Oh, yeah.
All right, here comes 2d6 damage.
Well, it was nice knowing you guys.
Oh, you have 17. You're fine.
All right, so 8 plus 3, 11 damage from that attack.
Oh, those are damage dice?
Yeah. Yeah, low level in 5th edition is horrifying. Like, things hit hard, nobody has a lot of HP. Most of these wolves would be dead. You gotta stay aggressive.
I know.
Everybody ran up and then ran away.
I nuked two of them and they just left me to die. They left me hanging in the wind.
I was playing support as well as
all right, back to the top. Bartholomew, your turn.
I feel like I can't charm this guy again.
Ivy, when it's not your turn, you should be planning out what you're gonna do on your turn.
So
you have a lot of powerful spells and abilities.
I'm trying to charm that guy. He was dumb enough to fall for a minor illusion, so he's probably not too wise. So I'm gonna be like, ah! And then I'm gonna cast minor illusion on the big guy.
All right.
Can I see this guy?
No, kill the guy with you.
Well, if you cast a spell right now, he's gonna get attack on you.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. Because you're
right next to him.
Yeah.
Kill him. He's already beat up.
Yeah, you're a bard. You can do everything.
True. Or pull out the sword, the long sword. Swing on him then.
Alright, swing on him. You're trying to hit an armor class of 14.
Can I see this guy?
Nice.
17.
Alright, you need some damage.
When I die. All right.
Long
very
sword.
Small monkey.
What?
Long sword?
A long sword's a
d8. Yeah.
I know what should happen before everybody gets hurt. They're like, wait.
7 plus
done,
strength.
Done,
negative
done.
1.
So 6 damage?
Okay, yeah, you can hit
it. Alright. You. Struggle to pull out your longsword, and in the process, you slash right across his chest. He lets out a howl of pain, and then his guts begin to spill out.
Ew.
He looks you right in the face, and a single tear starts to go down his cheek.
It was fun while it lasted.
And with bloody lips, he licks his thumb one last time, and he wipes that last bit of powdered sugar away from your chin.
He falls. Can I kick the body?
Spit on him.
I'm gonna take a free action to kick the body.
Alright.
Wait, can the wolves get scared?
The wolves cry out, "The boss is dead! The boss is dead!" Do you translate?
Yeah.
She's like just steady eating complimentary chips off the nearby table.
Pretzels. Can we get more pretzels here, man?
Draco, inside Draco's Fortress of Solitude, there is an enemy at the gates pressing against your force field, but he looks a little unsure. He hasn't been hurt yet, and this fight is going south fast. So he kind of has a look in his eye like, maybe I should head home.
Is it intimidate a free action, or do you have to?
It is your action to intimidate.
It's your action?
Yep.
Meanwhile, I'm staring this wolf in the face, and he feels like I'm burning through his skull.
Whoa.
Like,
that's an intense stare.
By this time, what, are you Fluttershy? Are you Fluttershy? Yeah.
So you think I can intimidate somebody?
Mm-hmm.
Well, what is intimidate?
Charisma.
Intimidate can basically coerce somebody in a mean way into doing what you want.
Yeah.
For a short amount of time.
Then you're like, do this or I'm gonna hurt you.
Yeah.
Okay.
And this is one of the fully healthy wolves.
Yeah.
It is charisma.
But it is if you press this advantage right after his boss got killed, I'll give you advantage on this check.
Okay. I'll try to intimidate
him. Johnny! Help, Alex.
Intimidation.
Tell how many people
scare a spineless noble into handing over their coin.
There should be a number.
Frighten a creature larger than you, causing it to flee.
20,
all right, go for it.
20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20
He wets himself. Then he starts trying to run away and tumbles, nudging these two, and he flees off in the other direction.
Where he tumbles, falls face first into the mountain.
Scared and confused, the wolf looks around for an exit, spying the window. Bash shakes his head.
Not again.
Outside, the gathered crowd yells, "Whoa! Did you see that? That wolf just jumped through the window!" Alright, you still have a movement. Do you want to use it, or do you want to use it to shore up your fortress? Maybe pull some more chairs in?
You build like a wall.
I feel like the buddy's gonna jack me up. Okay, so
I'm intimidated.
Would the bunny be able to jump up here with us if I jump to the next level?
Now. Can bunnies jump?
Just touching his
Well, I mean, would he have space? Would he have to jump all the way over?
He might have to jump on you.
You mean your darts?
He's a big boy. That's what they call him. They call him big boy.
Could I shoot him in the face if he tries to jump up there?
You would have the high ground, but you'd have to have an action ready for him to approach. And you just use your action to completely punk out that wolf and make him jump out the window.
As you do.
Yeah. I'll shore up my table fortress.
All right, shoring up the table fortress. All right.
He's pulling chairs in.
That brings us to the sheep.
There's a dead body next to
him. The sheep goes up and pees on guys.
Stupid guys.
But in doing so, he spots Big Boy, and his urine stream increases in speed and intensity. He begins to baa. Oh, that guy's a meanie. Oh yeah, that was a half ogre before he got turned into a bunny rabbit. He's definitely gonna mess us up real bad.
Bad.
Did you have to say that?
Absolutely. Absolutely. I would have failed in my profession if I had not. All right. That brings us to a big boy.
Charm Bash the Stampede to shoot everybody.
Big boy is looking around. Big boy is not too bright. Big boy's like, sees some action, 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 dead people, action. Here's the baa. Here's prick.
Try to stab him.
Alright, he's gonna try to climb over this railing.
Fail it!
Instead of climbing, though, he just grabs the railing and rips it out, and then he's going to use it to bludgeon Bartholomew over the head.
He throws. He gets him and throws him out the
window. Oh, there you go. He grabs Guz, and he's using Guz in his offhand. He's dual wielding Guz's dead body and the railing.
What?
Oh! It slams down. And you nimbly do your... The booth, needless to say, is destroyed. You hear baas of terror as the sheep just hides inside of itself, looking like a little cotton ball. It's so curled up. And then the bar to... Oh, no.
Every nod, I'm like,
it's okay. It's okay. It's
we got fine. This, we got this. This is good.
It goes in slow motion.
All right.
This is fine.
That brings us, everything's fine. Yeah, he just pours himself a hard whiskey from his personal stock. Okay, Ivy and Alex, what do Lotus and Monkey do? Monkey, you are toe-to-toe with a wolf.
I'm staring him in the eyes.
He's injured. You want to try to fight him?
Yeah.
All right, try to hit him. Let's do this.
Knock him out.
I'm going to use my short sword.
Dad, what's this guy's constitution?
That's kind of a personal question. Whose constitution? The big boy is
one of my spells.
He has a big constitution. Mm-hmm. It is higher than 13 for sure, but lower than 20.
Sure.
If at any time you would like 13. To perform a free action to roll a knowledge check, in this case you could use knowledge nature to find out about animals. Since there's some magic going on here, a knowledge arcana might give you some information as well. That lets players sort of find out more about stats while using in-game knowledge. What's up?
18 and 7. 7 for hit. And
most time it would be like, he's really strong.
18 on your attack roll, and it deals 7 damage, and he's already hurt. How does this happen? Do you kill him or do you knock him out?
I kill him.
Oh, dang.
I get my bow and arrow.
So you put away your sword after stabbing him, did you get
trained
up your
in 17 styles of martial arts, including Zen archery. Monkey.
I grab out.
He takes out her bow. Doesn't. take out an arrow because she doesn't own it. She takes the bow and just beats him over the head.
So like me and the Ender Dragon.
His last words, translated by the party druid, are "most embarrassing way to die."
The monk got bow and bow confused because they sound the same, but they're spelled differently. So she accidentally bought a bow.
The bow staff, right? That's what they said. I said I wanted a bow, and they gave me this. So
you hear that, monk?
I mean, I already paid for it. Once you already paid for it, you kind of gotta. Like, use it.
Yeah, absolutely. You don't want to admit you ordered the wrong thing. We've all been there. Yeah. You know, it shows up from the Amazon box. You're like, what is this? Oh, well, I'll make it work. Yeah. Okay. Druid Lotus. There are currently two wounded wolves.
All of you.
Three wounded wolves left? Yeah?
All right. Two wounded.
Two wounded, one fresh. The fresh one is closing in on you. This is the one that, on his turn, he's going to eat you. That's his plan.
I think I
want
to kill him.
He actually said it out loud. I'm going to eat you.
No, you're dying. Please don't eat me.
Whoa, you can understand me?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. It's been a long time since anybody could understand what I'm saying.
I've been really looking at it.
Well, I thought you were just crazy. I hope you don't take this personal, but the only way that I can get turned back by Devin the Masterful is if I do everything he says.
And he wants me to eat you.
Yeah, he's a real honest guy, too. Every time we do something, he tells us, just one more job, guys, and I'll turn you back to normal. It's been about 21 more times, but I think this might be the one.
Tell him you're a druid and you'll turn him back if he helps us.
Why?
No,
you just told
he doesn't know that! All he knows is you're a druid!
Lotus, the honest will not!
But my what? I'm actually honest!
Yo!
But if you lie to him, you can save his life.
I want to take a free.
Otherwise, we'll have to kill him. You don't want to kill him, do you?
And now you understand why honorable is a disorder in Kingdom Death.
Yes.
Evil will always win.
Alright, what is your. You do whatever you want, sweetheart. What are you going to do?
Lie. No! Stop that!
Haven't you ever watched Spaceballs?
No.
Evil will always win because good is dumb.
Good is not dumb. I'm just
really
weird.
I am on the evil campaign.
You gotta go faster on your spells, man.
Frostbite?
Do it.
I was just waiting for my chance to
switch
the body.
All
right. So what does Frostbite do? You cast a numbing frost to form on one creature. On a failed save, they take 1d6 cold damage and has disadvantage on its next attack roll. Alright. He gets a constitution save. Alright, constitution saving.
During this, I pull out a bag of popcorn.
Zero!
And the DC here is, what, 12? What's your wisdom?
My wisdom is...
3? So it's 13.
A few fingers.
Oh, it happened! Roll a d6.
How much damage it does?
Yes.
Plus nothing, right?
Let's see.
My prince.
Six.
Alright, 3 damage, and he has frost all over his mouth and his claws. He's going to have disadvantage on this attack roll. What attack roll? The one he's taking right now. Move that wolf into melee.
Can I still move?
Oh, you still have a move. Before he gets close to you, you going to move?
Moving would be a pain.
Alright, you scramble past Bartholomew right into the arms of the ogre rabbit, or do you go sideways into that booth?
Go sideways into the
booth. Alright. The wolf, now having a clear shot of Bartholomew, thinks to himself, that girl could understand what I'm saying. She has animal magic. Maybe I'll leave her for last. And he attacks Bartholomew instead. But he is on disadvantage.
During this, I pull out a pouch from my bag.
All right.
And start eating complimentary.
So he misses.
Be happy.
He would have missed even if he had advantage, even if we balanced it out. Those were terrible rolls. All right, so move that guy right up in your grill.
Take them out. You guys
got
started?
Yes. And they ran into the road. It was exciting.
I'm sure.
Yeah. He also unplugged one of our cameras.
Nice. He doesn't want to be on film.
No.
It's magical.
No, because you sat right in my lap on camera. He was loving it. He wants this to be the Inky Marathon.
Oh, wow.
Everyone all cuddles Inky for 25 hours.
Should we get a third camera? And just have Inky in the
room. We need a GoPro on Inky.
Exactly.
Yes.
Inky view.
That would be fabulous. But we didn't think of that. When you get to a good stopping point, it's after 10.
Okay.
Self-pickup.
No, we're focusing on this.
No, when you gotta go get my shelf.
I'll get
then
your
you
shelf.
Can come back.
And right.
Ron, we're on camera. Our friends are watching.
Yeah.
I know. You tell your dog. All right. All one of them. Gonna play.
All right.
Gonna play.
Do we have anyone?
We have one.
One viewer.
It might be us.
Oh.
No.
No. Oh, yeah, it is us.
But then no one saw our page.
Well, these are all being recorded and put on YouTube also, so.
What?
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Why are you YouTubing it?
Because for posterity.
Because we're going pro.
We're going to be celebrities.
Yeah. We're like beauty pies now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, we are not.
Yeah. PewDiePie makes 10,000 a month? More?
Yeah. Who does? A million half a year. Endorsements now. Yeah. Yeah. I don't know.
Should you
so,
say
NBD. No big deal. Yeah. I'm sorry. Yeah, I gotta stop saying that. All right, so the remaining wolves need to go. These guys, the bloodlust is upon them, but they are not animals. So they kind of stop what they're doing, and he looks over, and he's like, Joe, we can't do this. We can't be animals. We gotta reclaim our manhood. Well, the only way to do that is to get that sheep. But it's flipping nuts over there, man. They already knocked out Guz. They already knocked out, like... Oh,
I like that he's talking.
We need to get out of here.
They already knocked out Harry.
Let's go.
And
we'll just tell the boss
and Bob
that
already
we couldn't
ran
find
away.
It. Take me with you.
All right, so two more flee from battle. That means you just have the ogre bunny and the remaining wolf to deal with.
Are you guys happy I used frostbite on him?
Alright, that brings us to the next round.
I saved you.
Starting with Bartholomew.
So Ogre Bunny's on the top level?
Yeah.
Am I able to use my movement to get away, like, to not take this, or...
You'd have to disengage and then...
You have to spend your action, disengage, and then find a place to go at this point.
But he's trying to eat your sheep, though.
Because you're in a bad guy Sammy, and if you abandon the sheep, they will definitely just go after the sheep.
I'm gonna cast a charm person on the bunny.
Alright.
You're gonna charge
now,
the bunny?
If you do a spell in melee, both of them are gonna get attacks on you.
Yeah, but I can't move.
You can melee attack the wolf.
Yeah, just melee attack, man. Man up. Take that man part of your half elf and use it.
Yeah, but then he's going to crush me.
If you melee attack the wolf, Ivy can
it's
try to heal you on
one shot.
Her turn.
We'll just print you another character. It's okay.
I'm going with the charm. I think I'm gonna go. I will take.
You're gonna take
two hits. Yeah. You have like six.
Well, I'm not gonna kill him. Am I?
The wolf has.
I can't tell you what's gonna happen. You have to find out.
The wolf probably has like 10 hit points left.
Yeah, I'm not gonna do
but
that.
I can still hit him too.
And he's still at disadvantage.
And Ivy can heal you.
Very true.
I can?
Oh, or I could. Or
yeah,
I could,
you have healing.
I could be selfish. I could heal myself.
But you'd be casting
you'd
a
be
spell
casting
and
then
I'm casting a spell and then kill me.
As they start to realize why fighters exist.
Well, I knew when we were picking up, and no one was a fighter. She has a monk, at least.
Yeah.
Yeah.
A very tiny.
All right. I'm gonna stab.
All right, them. You gonna stab? Who are you gonna stab?
Stab the wolf.
Stabbing the wolf. Go for it.
I'm just gonna stab my way out.
Regular attacking the wolf.
Now it's a bow and arrow, but a bow.
Natural 10.
You need to get a 13 to hit.
Well, that ain't happening.
You sure?
What's
plus 5. What were you using, the rapier?
No. Wait, well,
that's your only weapon.
No.
So yes, you're using the rapier.
Oh, right. Yeah,
the
rapier.
Yeah, which is plus 5.
Yeah.
And one, one
D8
piercing.
Yeah, I would definitely go with that.
You can totally kill him.
All right, it does a D8 plus 3 damage.
Yeah, you could finish him with a good roll.
I hit in the tail with the bow and arrow because I panicked.
All right, you run the wolf through with your rapier. He lets out one last plaintive howl, interpreted by the druid. It says, I never got to see my wife and daughter again.
If only someone had talked to him. Talked him out of this course.
It's all good.
Yeah. If only about
don't carry that guilt with you. Don't carry that guilt with you. They
shows,
made their choice.
He tried to eat me!
Then it shows the wife and son and his children.
Draco, your turn. You're under the table in your fortress of solitude. There are no bad guys around. You can see ogre bunny ankles.
Wait, help me.
Can you maybe throw a dagger at it?
Dude, I got ice. And I still have a shot of chromatic orb.
Then maybe you can throw it at him.
No, I have ice beams too.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I meant See, because the only way to keep my shield up is using that level spell. So I think I'm going to hold on to my shield, and I'll just use cantrips to shoot the evil bunny.
Are you missing a die?
Maybe you could run away.
What?
And then he does this. It's impossible to stay on me.
I'm still going to shoot him.
Alright.
I'm just going to use, like I said, I'm going to use Ray of Frost instead of...
Ray of Frost? Are you off?
Yeah, Ray of Frost is like that. And it'll reduce his movement. And it's 60 feet. So
that's plenty, yeah. You're only 12 feet away, if you count the angle.
So I'll shoot him with the Ray of Frost.
Alright.
Do it! 20!
Sure, murder. Wait, what do I need to get anyway? Whoa. How do you know what you need to get to hit on the spell?
I think I might be able to.
It's just an attack roll. Certain spells will just have an attack roll. So you're going to add 2, which is your proficiency bonus, plus your relevant stat, which is your charisma bonus.
Oh, so add 4 to it?
Yep.
Okay.
Well, your charisma is 3, so it's actually plus 5.
Oh, okay.
You're not even, you're just spinning.
For your
d6. Oh! Alright. You go to launch your spell, and your hand shakes violently, and one tiny ice cube. And actually, then, not even an ice cube, just a snowflake. Just drifts out of your fingertips.
So, like, when and Twilight tried
luckily,
to
no one was around to see.
Oh.
So
when Twilight tried to cast.
I'm going to go to my max Ray of Frost distance. So, where would you say 60 away is from him?
Hmm?
Where would you say 60 away from him is?
5 feet every 1, 2, 3.
Well, he's also giving him a height bonus.
Oh, yeah.
If you're crawling, you can only move half your speed. So, you could just crawl to this table if you wanted to.
Oh yeah, that's cool.
Okay. No, stay out of notice a little bit. Alright, that brings us to the sheep's turn.
Can I be a chameleon dragon?
The sheep is tired of running. He's ready to fight.
Oh, this is ready to fight.
Plus 2, baby. Oh, 16.
Sheep making it interesting.
Something might be happening here. Oh, it hits! The sheep's vicious bite, because he does not have cool rams.
No, wait.
Did you try to butt him?
Oh, okay.
Knock him over the stairwell.
He is so weak, he has to use this die. This tiny die that you can barely see. It's a 1d3. Minus 1.
It looks like you're holding nothing on the camera.
Oh, dang. 1 point of damage.
Good job.
This stupid face.
See? This is a good
I believe
die.
That is first blood.
First blood.
A painful nip to the ankle. Alright. Sadly, that has drawn the ogre's attention. He is going to smash that sheep.
Did Ivy know?
No!
Did she start with that?
No, Ivy is delayed so much that she and Alex go on a 6 now. Alright. The ogre picks up his railing and his dead half-orc, and he proceeds to slam them down onto the sheep.
I thought he threw them out the window.
Ooh, that's an 11
what
plus.
What happens if the sheep dies? Does the battle end?
5. That's a 16. That does hit the sheep.
One.
Did I steal that from you, or is it? Is this yours?
No, that's not mine.
I'm terrible about just grabbing this.
Oh!
The sheep died.
16 points of damage to the sheep. You hear. It flops over, all 4 legs sticking straight up, rigor mortis in the air. Its tongue, bang.
They keep having like
6 hours.
He's probably like insta killed.
The ogre suddenly realizes he went too far. He was just supposed to catch the sheep, not murder the sheep. He looks around in a panic. His mouth working furiously, his nose twitching violently, his eyes bugging out.
Wait, he's not even
saying. He screwed up big time.
Yeah, he's not even saying anything. He's just mouthing the words.
He just starts making a low keening noise, like.
And then suddenly he yells, "I screwed up!"
I messed up
big time,
yep. I screwed up big time, bro! Which just sounds like a horrible screaming noise, because that's actually the sound rabbits make. They just scream. So, Bartholomew, you may make an attack of opportunity, because he is going to jump out the window.
Come on!
Oh, I'm
shoot him.
Yep, you're going for the hamstring.
Alright.
See what we got.
Six! You're a 11!
11.
That is a hit. He's a big boy. He's easy to hit.
All right. I even yelled an insult to him.
So that's 5 plus 3.
You know what?
Yeah, so 8. 8? Alright, 8 damage. Total of 9 damage so far.
As you go to do this, he trips going out of the window and crashes through it,
taking 5 more damage. And now his massive bunny rump is just facing the entire mermaid's mustache establishment, his tail twitching furiously, his legs kicking frantically as he tries to pull himself through the window.
Can I do what the owner of the tavern is doing?
A screaming sob just bursting from his mouth because he screwed up big time. What?
Can I show you guys what the bartender is doing?
What?
Nice.
Yeah, there aren't a lot of insurance agencies in the world of Dungeons and Dragons for just this reason. Yeah.
At least it was really nice when it started.
Yeah, but local construction companies, that is the way to go. Yeah. If you want to get rich.
Like, who cares about adventuring?
Yeah. Oh, you're an adventurer? I'm a contractor.
Yeah. You're like living in the noble's house. That's great.
All right. That brings us to the young lady's turn. Key, what are you going to do? There is a bunny rump. That's the only threat left in the room as he's trying to get out. Are you going to shoot him in the butt?
Yep.
All right. Using the magic of your 17 martial arts styles, you transform your bow staff into a bo-bo.
Bo-bo.
Pulling out an arrow. All right. Do it. You have advantage on his sweet bunny rump. To roll 2 20-sided dice, you get to keep the highest number.
18 and 10.
That is a hit. 18 for damage.
Sure. 18. What's the damage?
It's just on your
damage. 5. And then a hit ring. The hit is 1d4.
Okay. It's a little bow. A little person.
So do you actually need components?
If you have a focus, you do not need material components unless they have a price listed next to them.
3 plus 4 is 7.
So like 100. Pearl, golden pearl dust you would need, but like bat poop, focus will take care of that.
But a diamond.
7.
Yes. 7? 7 damage. All right. He's getting torn up, and he's letting out screams and howls of pain and frustration and embarrassment.
I feed on them.
Oh. Does that recharge your
from under the table, something? Obviously.
Mostly, he's just, the only words that you can make out, Ivy, are, I screwed up big time, I killed the Shine Bright,
I killed
Devin's
Senpai.
Gonna be so mad at me, I screwed up big time.
I killed Senpai. He killed Senpai.
Make sure the sheep, you should talk to the sheep and make sure it's dead. See if you can save him.
That's not bad.
Okay.
All right.
And I'm like, I put away my bow. My work here is done. Yeepee! Yeepee!
All right. You clear away the floating star emojis that are above the creature's head and try to tend to it. It is at death's door. It could die any second now if
there's
it doesn't receive some
butt.
Sort of magical healing.
There's this giant arrow in
I will
butt.
Use cure wounds on the sheep.
All right. You're going to use cure wounds. How does it work?
A creature you touch regains a number of hit points equal to 1d8 plus your spellcasting ability modifier.
Okay.
This spell has no effect on undead or constructs.
Okay.
It's a construct.
Which construct is like
golems.
A golem, a robot.
A building?
Yep. A building. It's literally a construct, yeah.
Too bad for the cavern owner. Too bad I can't heal the building.
You're gonna, yeah, right? There is actually a spell for that, though. Alright, so roll your, was it d8?
Yep,
d8. Alright, d8 plus 3. Roll it.
Four plus 3 is 7.
7. Alright. In 5th edition, no matter how negative your HP is, when you receive a healing spell, you start at 0 and you go from there. It's extremely generous. The good old days of Pathfinder 3rd edition where you're at negative 50 and it's a long haul to get back to positives, they're over. So he opens his eyes and he says, Stella, is that you?
No.
I smell toast. Is it morning already?
It's 12 o'clock.
It all sets in right away.
Don't look
he's
at the
in,
window.
He's in a mermaid mustache. Carnage and death everywhere. And he's still
like,
a sheep.
Don't look at the window.
There's this rabbit butt with a giant arrow in it.
Don't look at the window! Don't look at the window!
Why is there a giant bunny butt hanging out of the window?
It's a long story.
There's a big arrow in his butt.
Is that Stuart? That's probably Stuart. You're not gonna kill him, are you?
Stewie!
He's a good kid. He's just mixed up.
Oh, okay, we're not gonna kill him.
We just trust you.
He was lashing out. He's going through a lot right now. We all are.
Can't take him to the woman's
shelter.
Wait,
suddenly I hear whispers.
Kill him.
I shouldn't have made him angry.
No, it's not like that.
Yeah,
what?
You're going to
kill him.
Guys.
It'll make you stronger.
So should we stuff the sheep in the backpack so that he doesn't see it or what?
Like a bag of holding.
I think you have this well in hand, powerful druidess.
He's like,
I'll leave the rest to you. And he falls unconscious again.
Oh.
Wait, before he says, is Harry still here? He says, is Harry still here?
As soon as his eyes close, I blast him through the rare frost.
And then I look over.
Bartholomew, yeah, what's the plan? Fine.
I'm going to use this as mockery.
Oh, harsh.
Like,
due to his situation, you will certainly have advantage on this. Okay.
Killing a sheep?
If they can hear me.
Oh, he can hear
me.
Then
Ivy whispers to the sheep.
You'll have to shout it, though.
Wait, Ivy whispers to the sheep.
Hey man,
my friends are trying to kill it.
You suck
at
this.
I'm mocking you.
Like trying to stuff Harry's body under a table.
And then I'm under the table. I'm like, his mockery was so vicious.
I could see Wes's filter running. Like, it's like family friendly. PG. Like, every good insult's being like kicked back.
So, Dad, I'm trying to stuff him under a table. I tell the sheep. The sheep wakes up.
It hurt his feelings.
I wasn't gonna kill it.
So 1 point of damage, psychic damage to his feelings. He stops his bemoaning, and he says over his shoulder, "That really wasn't very nice. Good. I'm having a rough time with this."
He looks over and sees like a little orange tail.
So he's looking over his shoulder. I'm gonna shoot him in the face with a ray of frost.
I killed your friend.
All right, go for it.
Like,
you have advantage on this.
Harry's tail.
Was it a nat 20?
Yeah, it was a nat 20.
Alright, full damage. So what's the damage die on a ray of frost?
Congratulations!
It's
1d8. Alright, so 8 damage plus your ability score modifier, or is it just the...
I thought magic doesn't take a...
If attack rolls, it'll work.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Here.
Yes, baby.
Here.
But it keeps stuff like fireball. You can't crit with a fireball because it's based on saving throws.
You can't crit with lightning bolt.
Right.
Yep, 1d8 cold. And then he has a speed reduction in speed.
Oh, jeez.
Okay.
Wait, what?
At this point, you could end the fight either by declaring that you will coup de grace the bunny or that you will have the local constabulary shackle him and lock him in jail.
Does it look like he has cool gear?
He is a big rabbit wearing piecemeal leather armor. It's all a mess.
He's barely worth murdering.
No, I know.
You
want to
let him live?
I
want to
let him go into jail.
Let him go into jail.
Push him off the ledge. Well, we did tell the sheep we wouldn't kill him.
It's at this point that the local town constabulary shows up, as they often do, too late. What's going on here? Bristly mustache man says with his little blue police officer hat. Oh, this is some kind of riot happening in here. He looks over at the innkeep. You know, you're over your riot quota for the month there, Bash, the former stampede. You can't simply be having these sort of outbursts anymore.
It wasn't him. You might not believe us, but there was a giant bunny.
He's still stuck in the
window. Oh, we've been watching the whole thing from the street because we're too afraid to come inside. We know all about it.
Stone arrow in the bunny's
quite
blood.
Good.
Yes. All of my men, lock that bunny up. It will make a delicious stew. Oh, yes.
No, wait, no, don't eat it.
What do you mean?
It's just a bunny rabbit.
It's a person? No, it's a bunny wearing armor.
No,
it
used to be a person.
Well, that's true. I guess we would be cannibals if we ate it, and that is certainly against the law. All right, put him in shackles, lock him in jail.
But please, take that out.
We're going to put you in charge of this bunny rabbit. What's his name?
Yeah, the real name.
Stuart, the bunny rabbit. All
wait,
right.
You should have pronounced his name wrong. Can I
pronounce
his
nickname.
Name right
it's Stuart.
Quick?
The quotations, the bunny rabbit.
Stamos?
He's really up to one, Rob.
Yeah. Stamos?
Roger.
He goes by the bunny.
Stamos. I get a feeling we'll be able to tell who's who when he's down in lockup.
But please take an arrow out his butt first. I don't think that'll
You can retrieve that.
Well, because you stopped this disturbance, I won't fine you for unruly disorderly contact in a public place. Assuming you can, of course, present to me your charter stating that you are adventurers and therefore excused from these sorts of behaviors.
Talk our way out of it.
He's
clearly weak-minded.
I
put
it in. He's like, I thought there were. I just point to my card. He says, I thought there were four of you.
Adventurer's idea?
I thought there were four of you.
Usually the adventurer's board's all well and good, but you know there's rules to be followed here.
I'm just gonna like put a hand over the mouth of a charm person.
He's like, I thought there were four
of you. Oh! Unhand me, sir! Yes, of course your adventurer's trying to charm us in guard, eh? That's most unsightly.
I'm staring.
I'm gonna
at
have
him.
To fine you for that, sir.
My bow is just like this.
All right, Steven.
He's like,
pay the man.
25 gold!
I left my wallet in the car, so I'm gonna go out.
You see the way my bank account works.
What happened was.
I don't have any gold.
Lower the price.
Well, then, simply put, the only way I'm going to let you off today without locking you up for the next week or so is if you promise to track down the source of this evil and defeat it. Yes.
Oh, yeah, sir, yeah, huh.
All right, at least so we can't have intelligent wolves and bunny men coming to town.
I put away my bow and pull out my short sword.
Consider this an official quest. You'll notice that the yellow symbol above my head has now changed.
It's gray.
Yes, that's right.
I slice his hat off.
When you've completed the objective, please find me and I'll have plenty of waiting
for you. I know, I said hat. I sliced his hat off.
I want to search Gus's corpse.
I sliced his hat in half.
Gus has a pair of sweet machetes.
Machetes.
Oh yeah, possibly used in a movie at one time by a guy that likes machetes. All right.
What movie is that?
Machetes actually do have stats in Dungeons and Dragons. You can simply treat them as keen, which is to say they cause a critical on a 19 or 20 short swords. All right. And there are two of them. And they're flippin' sweet. The rest of his outfit is what you would expect from a half-orc trying to live the stereotype. You know, collection of skulls, furs, that sort of thing. So, there is, however, in his belt pouch, a picture of him and another man. This one appears to be somewhat short, with a pugnacious nose and a really bad bowl haircut. He looks like the kind of guy that even if you weren't a bully, you would want to pull his undergarments up into his butt crack. So, they seem to be arm in arm, each having a big jug of cider, and smiling as someone magically draws their picture.
Was it a Minotaur?
On the back it says, Devin and Guz, BFF.
BFFs? Best friends forever?
Yeah.
So that means the other one is Devin. We know what he looks like now.
I want to be like, man, I really want to beat that guy off for something.
Do you feel that way?
Ivy pays very close attention to the picture because she can cast illusions. So this is going to come in handy.
It's at this point that you hear the sound. You hear the sound of cowboy boots over broken glass and wood. You turn to see the 7-foot innkeeper, Vash, not the Stampede. He reaches up with one finger and pushes his sunglasses back dramatically, and then says, you know, I don't have insurance, and you just caused a lot of damage.
I'm just going to be like,
we
will
give them the wolf pelts as payment.
I know that you're honorable, because I was listening to everything that happened, and I know that one of you won't be able to sleep at night, knowing what you've done to my life.
I'm just gonna walk out of the bar.
And that's why I'm gonna let you make it up to me.
I pull Harry out and start like viciously throwing him.
How can we make it up to you?
Well, my cat went missing a few weeks ago. Well, maybe it was a few days ago. It's hard to keep track. Anyways, if you see my cat while you're out adventuring, which I have a feeling you will, because that's how these one-shot adventures seem to go.
Cat with this
bring the cat back to me, and we'll call it square.
I will turn this wolf alive.
Otherwise, I am gonna need about 400 gold to cover the repairs and damages.
But what? We could just not come back.
I use that stand that I used. We could go to the tavern.
We'll get a description of the cat, though. We get the description.
The cat is. What was the cat? It had like.
Pause.
Four legs. It was so cute. It was so cute. It made a cute little face.
Did it have a piano?
No. But that would be cool.
Like, can you work?
Yeah, that's something to think about. You know, I think it was black. I'm very sure it was black. I know it's missing because we have a lot more mice than we normally do.
Wait, suddenly Lotus finds a picture outside. She takes it off the wall and says, does this look like your cat?
No, that cat is too fat. My cat was very skinny and black.
Can I cast, like, under my breath, can I cast Minor Illusion?
Of a black cat?
Just,
does
like,
this look like your cat?
You shouldn't do that to bash the stampede.
Okay! No. Don't say anything about it!
So yeah,
honestly,
Minor Illusion.
My cat looks like.
Okay,
that's
so I'm not trying to tell you that you've been given a quest, but...
There's a quest, yeah.
What?
Alright.
Are these two dead?
Oh yeah, I guess we should take a look at them, huh?
Yeah. I'm gonna shake him down.
I'm right next to that.
Captain Mustache's mustache twitches violently, and he says, "Oh, tut-tut, we're gonna need some healers in here. Oh, it looks like those wimpy Alliance guys got their butts kicked again."
They're just, like, taking stuff off their body.
Does anybody else know a healing spell? This guy needs a
Well, I say, what are you doing there? I'm gonna have to add that to your list of charges.
Checking to see if they're okay. Like, yeah.
No,
I'm gonna I will distract Mustache.
No, okay.
Yeah, I'm gonna talk to Mustache. And you guys, I'm gonna say out loud, "Hey guys, go make sure they're okay."
Oh, very noble, very heroic. Yes. Oh, good.
Nice
good.
Sword.
Did I see blind anything? Can I make an assessment check on their bodies?
Oh, sure, yeah.
This guy's still like half alive.
As a bard, you're only partially a rogue, so it takes you a little bit longer to perform the looting that is the birthright of every murder hobo in the universe.
These guys like still half alive.
You quickly rifle through their pockets, and like any alliance, they're overloaded with money they bought from Chinese eBay sellers. So you find 40 gold coins.
Yay!
All of the weapons and armor they're wearing are purely ornamental. None of them would actually stand up in a fight.
But they look good.
Yeah. For all intents and purposes, they're made of Warbler. These guys were cosplayers. It's that bad.
What about their swords?
even the swords. They're just made out of foam core.
And I'll ask the constable if he's ever heard the name Devin.
Devin? Yes, I have. He was born here in the town, but showed magical prowess like we'd never seen before. So we sent him off as a baby to go live with the powerful elven wizard, Shinebright.
Shinebright.
Yes, he lives in a magical treehouse fortress in the haunted woods outside of town.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
The woods is full of ghosts and spiders.
That's like a beautiful
place. I feel like that
Oh, yes. Actually, for a Dungeons and Dragons forest, it's pretty low key.
Hey.
And we'll also ask if you've seen a cat around. Well, we can't describe the cat, so it won't really help.
Well, there's been a lot of cats.
I've seen a cat before.
Yeah, I've seen a cat.
Well, as far as that's, I'm not even sure Mash knows what his cat looks like. So, honestly, I think we can't bring any cat back.
How many cats have you seen in the past 3 days?
That is a very tough question. So, like, really hard.
It's like his hobby.
Pretty much as soon as we leave the tavern, we should do a cat spot check. Just for any cat in the
By the end of the game, you just dump out a sack. It's just all the cats you found during your adventure. It's a collection quest.
I was about to say, yeah.
It becomes...
Is it a recurring quest?
If you find all 50 cats, you unlock an Apache helicopter.
Yeah. He's the last boss you
read.
The last boss is a dragon that breathes cats. Like, it's a breath weapon, it's just cats.
Is this more... What's the cat from that... For Trigun's name? Word cat?
I don't think it ever had a real name.
People gave it a name.
They snuck it into every
episode.
Yeah,
he's always there.
He's like the Where's Waldo.
Yeah.
And he might be right over there.
Yeah.
Alright, we're gonna pause right here. And then we will continue after we go pick up a board game shelf. It is going to fall on the young ladies to play a game in the meantime while we go and grab this shelf. We're going to stop the stream. We'll continue when we come back. We're on the honor system here. You got to imagine that we're playing video games and board games. Unless you guys want to stream while we're gone. All right. We'll be back. Bye.